Hello, everybody out there, and welcome back to another Dark Avenger comic book review. I am feeling better. Unfortunately, it's really late in the week for books that came out on
March 8, 2016, the first week of March.
Yeah.
No, second week was March 1st.
Second Wednesday of March, you could say.
What's the second week of second
anyway, week? We are here. We made it finally. There was no Dark Avenger Live tonight. So tonight, we have something special. Not only do we have this Dark Avenger comic book review, but if you've been following, there will be another live show later on tonight. Me and Brant will be continuing, Brant and I, if you want to get correct grammar, Brant and I will be delving back into the awesomeness that is Iron Fist, which dropped last night at 3 o'clock a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 12 midnight Pacific Standard Time. We watched the first 4 episodes. It was awesome. Give you a little bit of a teaser there. We're going to watch the next 4 or 5 episodes, and then we're going to do another 4, well, not in one show. We'll explain when we do the show, but we are going to attempt to watch another 4 or 5 episodes tonight we'll explain later, like I said, and then our goal in whole is to finish the entirety of Iron Fist by maybe weekend's end or maybe Monday, depending on how we both feel and where we're going.
And the brothers in green would like to wish all of you out there happy St. Patrick's Day. Hopefully all of you out there had a happy and great one. Yep. I was going to say healthy one, but great
and
one.
And we are filming this live, so if we do answer comments, that's because comment bar is up on the side. So
without further ado, let's get started.
The sooner we get started, the better, because I got to get ready for later on.
Yeah. So this is a book that we both read, and we're happy to review this, and that is Niobe, issue number 3, by our great friend Larry Higgins.
Oh, man. Oh, my God.
This issue.
Yeah, wasn't it?
Dude, like, Niobe just gets better and better. There's like, it starts off like when she goes at this photo shoot. And they have some great artwork in there, by the way. Really gorgeous artwork when she goes for the photo shoot.
Link in the description if you'd like to check out where. We're going to start doing that with all the books we talk about, even when it comes to Argo Comics. From now on, we're just going to say the link is in the description below. We're going to have links ready, especially since we do these live. We'll have links automatically in the description.
Yeah, and in this book, she has this huge battle against that big character with chains. I can't remember what.
The werewolf. It was a werewolf.
Yeah, the werewolf, yeah. And the fight was, like, really intense, but it turned out that it wasn't just a werewolf. It was a little boy.
Yeah, that was the big twist at the end, was, like, they were fighting this werewolf. They wanted to kill it. Niobe finds out it's a boy, and she stops them from killing the werewolf.
Yeah, once again, that's what I like about her character. They don't believe in killing. They believe in bringing people to justice or to help them. And that's what I love about Niobe's character. But in the end now, they left us on a huge cliffhanger where somebody else now is on a hunt for Niobe.
Mm-hmm. That last page teases the future.
Oh, that chick looks like she means business. And let me tell you, I cannot wait until issue 4 drops.
Oh, well, we will. There are 2 Kickstarters we will definitely be funding, and it is the Niobe 4.
Definitely.
And there's another Kickstarter that's going up. Funding for other reasons, but we will be doing 2 Kickstarters so far this year. We will be backing, and we'll see what other Kickstarters pop up. We already got Cats also, by the way. So we also funded Cats, so that's our first one. We have 2 more that we want to do.
Like Father, Like Daughter.
Yes.
Yes.
So we're definitely backing a lot of really great comics this year so far. I'm looking forward to what other comics will be coming out. I think also Pat Chance counted for this year, didn't it? Destiny New York, was that?
Oh, yeah, that was almost the end of the year, but I think it was on the new year also, wasn't it?
I think so. We will definitely be backing Niobe issue 4. I love the artwork in this issue. Was really great. The story, once again, it was action-packed with that fight with the werewolf. I love how there was how'd you like the pinups when they were doing the photo shoot?
Yeah, I was talking about that.
Larry was smart. He put the pinups in the middle to make it look like it was one big photo shoot. And instead, it was like all these artists doing different pictures of Niobe on the beach. That was good. That was really good. Really smart.
And she was enjoying it too.
I've never seen somebody do that. I'd love to. We got to figure out a way to get Niobe physically to get him signed for our wall. Yeah, I looked up on the website. We got to find a way.
Deserves to go on this wall right here.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We just got to figure it out because the shipping is a bit extreme. Yeah,
but still, it's something to have at least. But guys, definitely check out Niobe's issues 1 through 3.
Amazing.
When issue 4 comes out, both of us will definitely be reviewing that.
And we will be reviewing a new series, which has also 3 issues in it.
Yep.
Now, I'm going to give you guys a little bit of a setup for that. It's not from our friend Larry. It's from another friend of mine, Colin. I'll give you his full name next week. I'm going to give the disclaimer now that Larry's book is definitely teens and above.
It is.
The next book is for more mature readers. And I've already skimmed the first issue.
I have yet to see it.
Yeah, I think Michael and I this time are going to sit through, we're going to read through all 3 issues together. Even though we both now read all 3 Niobe's, I think this time we're going to sit through each of the issues together and attack it the same way. Because now the book, which title I will not even tease yet, but it's a bit more for mature readers. So this book will be for more adult. We'll talk about that, like I said, next week.
All right. So now let's get into the books of March 8th, starting with this one.
Nancy Drew and the Hardy Boys, issue 1.
How was that book, actually?
It was garbage.
Really?
Not garbage. I shouldn't say it like that. I didn't like it. I just can't get into... First of all, I didn't like the artwork. I really just couldn't get into it because of the artwork alone. And then the story itself, and then when you see Nancy Drew at the end of the book, I mean, we all knew it was coming. We all were like,
well, Nancy Drew did work with the Hardy Boys in the novel books as well.
If you would have seen this comic, you would understand.
Well, I didn't. I thought maybe it was because you read Nancy Drew and Hardy Boys.
I read the Hardy Boys.
Oh, you read with Nancy Drew? I thought you read with Nancy
Drew. I read one Nancy Drew book.
Or maybe one. That's what I've probably, yeah.
But no, I can't feel a connection with this series at all. And I really do not like the artwork. I didn't like it. Uh-huh. It didn't connect with me on many levels. It has nothing to do with even the changes. It just didn't connect with me on multiple levels. Even if I never read a Nancy Drew or a Hardy Boy book, I still would not be interested in continuing to the next issue. I will not be going to the next issue of Nancy Drew and the Hardy Boys. That's just not happening.
All right, then. Okay, so now it's my turn, starting with Dave Ocrosity, issue 2. Dave is running for president, but there's someone else that's stepping in his way that's running for president who is trying to be better than Dave. And we all know David's son, Scotty, you know him with his ways of being like this this kid who wants to be everything. But he's trying to get connected to his father, but it's more along lines of just trying to help him win as president. But you still get that bad side of him a little bit. Mm. This issue was really great. It was long dialogue, a little chaotic in the end because it's now the people who support Dave versus the people who support the other president. I can't remember what his name was. I'm really upset about that because I remembered and then I forgot. But it's going to be an all-out war in the next issue because Dave just wants peace because he can't fight or anything because he's going for president. So he can't really do anything. John Carter, the end, issue 2. Now, the artwork is still a little bit meh, like the last issue, but this one was an okay issue. Like, it's still DJ Torres, who was looking for John Carter's son on the planet. And, you know, it was a little bit boring because they're just looking around, trying to find out, you know, where he is. And then we get a little bit of a backstory, excuse me, about how, he left them on his planet or something. Yeah. But in the end, though, we do see John Carter and DJ Torres' son. And it looks like that he wants to do harm a lot in Barsum or Mars. I think that's where they were. But really something else. Can't wait to see how that son's going to turn out. Day of the Dead, issue 2 from Zenescope. Excuse me, I got a little tickle. And in this one, like, how can I explain? It's like the spear follows her no matter where she goes. And she has to, like, do all these tasks. And if she fails, then she has to live the life of this person. So I don't want to give too much away because I want you guys definitely to read it. Okay? But I really enjoy this issue, action-packed. And definitely some for all of you to read. Hellcha the Unholy, issue number 4 of 5. In this issue, Angelica is doing this war thing and fighting for her father, Hades. So what she does is that she works with Jezebel. And this person who she fights with in the beginning is offering her so much, like saying, oh, I can give you this, I can give you that, only if you follow the stuff that I do. And it's just like a whole big talk scene where she goes to Jezebel. And then when
Jezebel.
Yeah, Jezebel. Here's the really messed up part, though. In the end, as they're about to fight this creature that she fought in the beginning, she decapitates Jezebel, Angelica. Wow. And she's like saying, so about this whole ruling thing, you know, like what's going to be of that? And welcome, Mr. Gretzky, 9966.
Mr. Gretzky, what's going on, man?
Great to have you here on this comic review. All right. And, oh, and also Renfro.
Jeremy Renfro in the house also. That's great.
All right. Grim Tales of Terror, Volume 3, Number 2. This issue was really, like, in a scary story way. Wow, I got this really strange tickle. See what the...
Well, get through it, and then we'll go.
I know, but what I have to say is that it's about these group of students who go into this mansion, and they have this story about like so many things they have to do, and there's an arm there that is the murderer of everyone. Like, there's one that hangs from the ceiling. There's one where this guy gets it really bad. I mean, it's a really gruesome book. I mean, I'm surprised you're not reading it.
Tales of Terror is okay. I might read it. You know, I actually started looking, since Iron Fist, I started looking into trade paperbacks. And there are, I think I'm going to make a specific playlist, a specific wish list on Amazon for trades. Because I just went looking for Iron Fist. But through Iron Fist, I found a couple of Hulk trades I liked, a couple of events that I like, a couple of other books. Like, they kept recommend. I hate Amazon. They're the worst because they recommend shit to you. And it's like they know. They know your mind and they know what you want. So they put it there. And there are a lot of trades that I want to get. And, I mean, maybe it would be better in trade. I mean, we did say we were going to be getting a lot of the digital stuff we're getting in trades now. And that's going to hold true for a few books. Right now, we're not getting anything like when X-Men Blue, X-Men Gold, stuff like that. And the beautiful thing about it is DCBS is partnered with, or their sister company is in stock trade.
Yeah.
In stock trade. And they have amazing deals on new and old trades. Problem is, I don't know how you order old trades because I think you have to wait till the end of the month. So I'll still stick with Amazon for older trades unless they have like
a huge bargain. The release date also when they come out.
That's true.
As well.
So, I don't know, but I might look up some stuff on In Stock Trade also, see if maybe they're cheaper. I just got to figure out their shipping. If they ship immediately, then that's great. But if they don't ship immediately, I'll pay the extra $5 to get it on Amazon and get it in 2 days.
Yeah,
but just old Hulk books are awesome. I'm thinking of getting Mr. Gretzky. I know I shouldn't be interrupting because we should get through this because we have Iron Fist. But one book I would love to get with Hulk is the 2-volume Jeff Leob Red Hulk run. I'd love to get that. Larry Lawhorn. Hey, Chris, did you get Amazing Spider-Man issue 25? No, we'll be getting our new books, I guess, tomorrow. The blizzard held everything up an extra day, so we didn't get our books today, so that means we'll get them on Saturday.
But going back to Grim Tales Terror, excellent story. You guys definitely have to read that.
Mm-hmm.
Street Fighter versus Darkstalkers issue number 0, which I did review on Comic Frontline, so I'll just keep this short. The story is all about the Darkstalker side. The artwork is amazing in this comic book.
Let me hit your chest.
What are you doing?
Trying to make you cough it up because you're making me want to cough just hearing it.
Well, sorry.
The Frog Queen. What's up? Oh, my God. Nice to meet you. Great to have you on the show. That's a really cool name. I don't know why, but I read that and it's like, that's awesome. That's an awesome name. The Frog Queen. I like that. That definitely has like a superhero status. She's the Frog Queen. It's like Squirrel Girl versus Frog Queen. Who would win? Frogs or the squirrels?
Maybe frogs.
Frogs will give the squirrels warts. That's an awesome name. Welcome to the show. It's from Jeremy Ikenzau. Nice.
All right. So it starts off where Jedha's working with Lord Gil, and they're somewhere working together as an alliance. The artwork, look at this. Really amazing artwork. And it's about a master working with, what's his name? Azim. And they meet up with the Pharaoh. But Azim actually is getting transported where we don't know. But I think the next person they're going to be going after now is Chung Li.
And I think they're taking a 2-month break before issue number one.
Actually, no. It's coming out in April.
Okay. Yeah, that's right. I did get it in for April. That's right. I completely forgot. So I forgot. What really cover did I get? Did they show all the covers? I think I got the main cover. Yeah, I think I got the main cover. Yeah, but no, that's cool.
Yep, a really great book. Definitely gotta check it out. Yeah, I'll be right back. Excuse me, I have to get some.
Street Fighter games are awesome. Hell yeah. All right, TMNT Universe issue number. I don't want this to shine. Issue number 8. This is a crazy cover. If I was on Frontline Live this week, this probably would have won my favorite cover because it's just so crazy. So Metal Don, you know, he's screwed up in the head. You know, his programming is messed up. Oh, hell yeah, Frog Queen. Massive TMNT fan right here. And he escapes, and now Donnie goes to his brother's. I love the way, I don't know, for some reason, the artist in this book catches facial expressions with the turtles really well sometimes. I really do dig the way he does, and especially Mikey, who's so upset right now because he's sitting watching the guys play. I got the new Digimon game. Oh, that's awesome, man. The cover is awesome. So Donnie goes to his brothers, and they find out that Metal Don, because they still call him Metalhead Metal Don because he still has Donatello's emotions and his mind and his brain. So it turns out that he went to, Harold's old laboratory and found a gigantic version of himself that Harold was working on, a gigantic Metalhead. And he downloads his subconscious into the giant Metalhead. But in reality, he just wants to end his life. So he's just trying to destroy himself. Wow. And the turtles won't let him. And I love how he's like, remember, you brought this on yourself. And he basically, we think he's going to self-destruct. And in the end, he doesn't self-destruct. He basically internally self-destructs. He erases his feelings, his emotions, everything. So basically, all of the Donatello in Metalhead is now gone. So whatever emotions or whatever part of Donnie was still left in Metalhead is now gone. Now it is just a cold thinking machine. So there is no Donatello in Metal Don anymore. So it is just Metalhead. And as a matter of fact, Donnie actually stopped himself from saying Metal Don and goes back to Metalhead because we all know that it's Metalhead now.
Yeah. So that's something else. Larry says, Michael, how are you? Well, I'm doing great, man. Just had a little tickle, but I'm okay.
Wanted to remind you guys. Oh, yeah, that's cool, man.
Oh.
Mike has not, but I will talk about that in a moment. But this is a really good book. I didn't read the secondary story. I'm not really interested in the secondary story. I hear something in the background. I'll check it in a moment.
Yeah. And MT also, what's up?
I've not read a turtle comic since The Adventures of the Nights. Oh, you should definitely be checking that book out. It's really good. How long have you guys been on YouTube? Okay. It's a long story.
You mean individual-wise? Or?
I'm going to go the whole history. We started on YouTube, me and Michael and a few of our friends, on a channel called Brooklyn Boys.
With a Z.
Brooklyn Boys 13. And that was about 10 years ago. My personal channel, and Michael's was, I think, the same, around the same time, a year earlier. Yeah,
around.
So he's about 10.
I'm going to be almost 10 years, July 2nd. That's right. Going to be a huge celebration.
That's him. Me, I started Dark Avenger, my personal channel, I think it was back in
2009 in August.
He memorizes dates and schedules.
Because
me. Anyway, yeah, I started.
How did you not know that? It's your channel.
I started back in 2009, my personal channel, Comic Frontline, started as Dark Avenger Inc., and that was back in 2008, No.
2011, I think.
11, right. Because of the breakup. Yeah. 2011 was Dark Avenger Inc. Comic Frontline, this channel, which we evolved from Dark Avenger Inc. into. Dark Comic Frontline started about 3 years ago.
February the Frontline, 2013.
So there you go. That's the history. I don't know why I even bother opening
my
mouth.
I'm sorry. I'm helping you out here. I mean, instead of you going,
yeah,
like,
we've
I'm
been.
Like, well, you, I'm helping you.
Thank you for shutting up. Yeah, we've been on YouTube for a while. My personal channel is really where I started doing the comic book stuff, though.
Yep.
Brooklyn Boys with Skits. And Mike's channel is gaming and skits. And
wide variety.
I just started
videos,
my channel not too long ago. That's awesome, Frog Queen. What do you do on YouTube? Do you do comics, or are you into another type of genre? Let us know. I'm actually gonna open up your channel in another tab, and I'll check it out later. Let's do that now. I'm just.
I can't
switch to my personal channel right now, but. Slot, yeah, you are comic book. Yeah, oh yeah, we definitely, I will definitely be subscribing. Everybody go sub who's in the comments. I know this isn't Dark Avenger Live, but everybody in the comments, I review comics and I interview guys. Everybody in the comments, MT, Larry, I know all you guys, we do this on Dark Avenger Live, but it's Friday. But guy, oh good, you're a comic junkie. Subscribe to my channel and this channel and you're going to love it. We have lots of comic stuff we do all the time. My channel is Dark Avenger C86. We're Comic Frontline. And Comic Frontline has everybody. We have Cat, Comic Uno. There's a lot of us. If you go to the Frontline main channel page, you will find everybody on Frontline
and
has their
Rocket
own channel.
Team.
Even you do the game. Yeah, you got a wide variety. Yeah, you got a wide variety too.
Yeah.
But yeah, everybody in the comments, go over to Frog Queen and subscribe.
The
Frog Queen and go subscribe to her channel. It looks really awesome. Can I do it? Would I be able to do it? I don't have the screen up. Let's see if I can do that and this. And then go back here and then share. Let's see if it works. Oh, my eyes. So there we go. The Frog Queen. This looks like a really awesome channel. I can't wait to delve into it. We're definitely going to delve into it. We got a lot of videos. I saw a lot of videos. 133 subscribers. Let's push her up to 150, guys. We can. You see the link right up here? You guys can go to her channel and go check it out. It looks like there's a lot of really awesome videos we got to check out.
Oh, yes.
What am I currently reading? Oh, that's going to be the first. That's perfect. Episode one. I will definitely. I'm going to leave. I want to leave the main channel so I could click sub on my personal channel. Whoop. But, yeah, we will definitely be checking out Frog Queen, the Frog Queen's channel. So go check her out and give her a subscribe. I don't have a bookshelf, so I store my trays. Paper. Dude, I don't have a bookshelf either. See up there? See right there? This is a about 80% of my trade paperbacks. No shelf. My shelves are all dedicated to like Marvel Legends and figures and there's some more trades up there. So yeah, I understand the sentiment of not having a shelf 100%. Definitely. Oh, I'm glad. Well, Frog Queen, I'm glad you found our channel the other day. I'm really glad. I'm glad that you found this live show. You know, we found so many people in the past. There's a funny story, Frog Queen. We found so many really great people in the past couple of weeks. They bump into Dark Avenger Live or this comic review live, and we made some really nice friends. So, Frog Queen, number one, I hope you keep in touch. I do a live show every Friday, Dark Avenger Live. We have a live show every Tuesday. Frontline Live, that's where the whole group is on. And then my channel, I'm going to start doing some sporadic comic reviews and comic stuff again. There's a whole, if you subscribe to my channel, you'll understand what's going on later on. There's a video series that's going on right now that's going to be awesome. And we got Mr. Gretzky subscribed. MT, I don't have, yeah. I store my trade paperbacks and hardcovers in a box. They'll be fine. That's where I put a lot of my. That's where I put a lot of my stuff. That's where I put a lot of myself. MT. Jeremy said the same thing. All right, but we spend a lot of time. Well, I wanted to promote Frog Queen, so I'm looking for your Dark Avenger channel. It's this. I wish we had Alan in the comments. You just do youtube.com and then do the slash, and then you put that, and you'll find my channel. But let's go out, and let me know if you find it. If not, I'll find a way to get the link to you. Nova.
Number four.
Okay, so the mystery of, oh my God, why did his name leave me? Of Zack Ryder is getting deeper. And I think Zack is starting to realize himself that he's not all there. We get to see him and Gamora, which is awesome. Now, here's the part I didn't like about it. Well, not that I didn't like. The artwork on certain pages, the way they drew his sister in the previous volume is very different than the way they draw her now. And the way they even write her now is kind of more immature.
Really?
A little bit.
I don't know. I didn't read the book.
A little bit. And I didn't really... Oh, nice. That's great, Larry. I heard Ghost Rider was canceled. I have no clue. But I don't know. I didn't like the artwork. I did like Sam's first date with this new girl. I thought that was really cool. Found it. Good. It was an okay book. We got to see Sam on his first date. We got to see Gamora and Zack having a bit of fun. You know, and then something happens with the sister. The sister's home alone with the grandmother. And then something happened. Remember we had that little blob that was in Sam's helmet?
Oh, yeah.
Let's just say bad things look like they're going to be happening.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Ooh, I knew stuff was going to be with that blob sooner or later. Wow.
So I'm interested in seeing what happens. And I think that Zack is connected to it. Richard Ryder, not Zack Ryder. Richard. Nobody corrected me. Ooh, yeah, I was. And nobody corrected me? Really? Well, no one corrected me. Richard Ryder. You know, so this is what happens when you watch. Yeah, I don't watch wrestling anymore, though. So I watch it sporadically here and there, but wow. But yes, Richard Ryder. So he's going back to Sam now because he I think he's somehow connected to the monster. Very interesting stuff. Man-Thing issue number one, written by R.L. Stein.
Oh, the one that does Goosebumps?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow.
Look at the cover.
Well, I didn't look at the cover yet. Now I'm going to look at the cover. R.L. Stein, wow.
Huh. I didn't really care for it.
Really? Another novel book?
Okay. Man-Thing was cured during a specific book, and I remember reading it, too, that he was cured. He got his mind back. Oh, yeah. How is that? I haven't read the new Man-Thing yet. I'm going to explain it. So the new Man-Thing was cured. I forgot where and when. It leaves my mind, but I did read it. And I remember he was able to talk again. He wasn't an animal. He was human again. And what happened is he went back to normal life. And he's doing these commercials, whatever. And then out of nowhere, the animal version of it, and you get a backstory. You find out what caused this person, or the origin of Man-Thing. And then you get this other Man-Thing that shows up out of nowhere and wants to fight the real Man-Thing. And that monster version wants to drag him back to the swamps and basically turn him, you know, into a mindless beast again.
Interesting. A little bit, I guess. Unless it's already been done?
I don't know. I'll tentatively read issue two, pending if it's a light week like this week. I don't know how I feel about it, honestly. I want to like it. I liked R.L. Stein's writing. I just don't know if I do like it.
We'll have to see.
Yeah, that's it. Now, I never reviewed a single part of this book. Not a one, but I'm going to review the last part, and that is Inhumans versus X-Men, issue number 6. Now, as you guys know, I was reading this on the side. I've read it. Current 3-part with Green Arrow. Good, nice to have Ollie. Oh, okay. We're talking about Green Arrow. So, this issue went all different kinds of all over the place. One thing I liked was Emma Frost is now a bad guy again.
Oh, who didn't see that coming? I thought she was a bad guy in the beginning.
I would have loved for them to have admitted that she was the one brain controlling. We got Ron Price in the house. I hope the Mandy will be good. I have high hopes for it. I hope it gets better. First issue was okay. I don't know. I don't know how I feel about it yet. I need another issue. I've never read Man-Thing before. A person who did read Man-Thing before was very disappointed in the book. I personally have to see another issue before I can really definitively say whether I would continue reading it or not. Yes, thank you, Jeremy. This book felt rushed and forced. It was rushed because the entire problem that was going on in those seven issues, it gets resolved.
Six issues.
Well, there's going to be a...
Well, yeah.
Anyway, boom, resolved. Like that. It was resolved. What? That easy. The little girl with Devil Dinosaur, Moon Girl, created a remote to destroy the mist. And apparently Medusa didn't know that the mist was killing mutants. It was on the news. It was all over the world that the mist was killing mutants. But for some reason, Medusa had no clue. And that's cool that you have the original story. Once I get a job, I'll do Spider-Man reviews for Stan from Stan Lee era. That'd be cool, man. All the way to Dan Slott. I don't know. I didn't like it. It felt like, you know, if you guys remember Avengers versus X-Men, this really just landed it right on the head. The X-Men, you know, it ends in a team-up, as every Versus does. The X-Men and the Inhumans have to team up to fight against now Emma Frost, who creates these Sentinels to destroy the Inhumans. Her goal wasn't just to destroy the Mist. It was to destroy the entirety of the Inhumans. And then, of course, the X-Men and the Inhumans win. Emma Frost gets saved, spoiler, by Havoc, of all people, because he feels like he owes his brother something. And then, I hate Emma Frost, Frog Queen. That's one thing I can tell you off the bat. I don't like her, and I'm glad she's evil again. So, in the end, Emma Frost is now public enemy number one between the X-Men and the Inhumans. Medusa decides that to keep our people, to give hope to our people, I have to go back with Black Bolt. So she tells Johnny, thank you for all the memories. And then the last panel of the book, you see her in Black Bolt's bar. And basically, you know what's going to happen. They're going to get back together.
Of course. You could see that a mile away.
Mm-hmm. And that's that. That's the book. So basically, we're going to see the Inhumans go up into space. The X-Men going to rebuild their group, the gold and the blue. And that's it. The Terrigen Mist is gone. And problem solved in one issue. In one issue. We went five issues watching everybody fight. And I want to know another thing. How the hell did Medusa take out Psylocke like that? Nobody could take out Psylocke like that. But for some reason, she took Psylocke out in one snap.
Then again, X-Men stories are changing differently.
I don't know,
with their characters wise.
I didn't like this mini. I really think that this was just a reason to send the Inhumans into space and to bring the X-Men or try to fix the X-Men. Will this happen? Fingers crossed for blue and gold. I can't understand why the X-Men books have been so bad lately. They had to ruin my favorite. I'll tell you, Frog Queen, the last time I enjoyed X-Men was right before Schism. When Wolverine and Cyclops divided into two, that's when things really went down the shitter for the X-Men, right there at that moment. Not loving Black Bolt again out of the left field. Now Johnny's like Ben wandering. Yeah, until the Fantastic Four get back together, Johnny is just wandering aimlessly. But let's move on.
18.
The Flash issue number 18. I love this one because Barry takes, Wally and Iris to breakfast with his dad. It was really, really nice. That was a while ago. Exactly. That was a long while ago, Frog Queen, and they haven't been the same ever since. I loved it. It was a nice breakfast, and then I love how Barry's dad takes him on the side, and he says, do they know that you're the Flash yet? And Barry's like, no, not yet. And he's like, I could tell that Wally's Kid Flash just by the way you guys talk and the way he talks. So I think it's time maybe you tell Wally and Iris, especially if you're in love with Iris or if you guys are dating, because it's just going to get harder down the road. That was the best father advice I've ever heard. I love that. And then you got Wally who leaves. He takes a walk and Flash goes after him, you know, because it's his training or whatnot. And Wally confides in Flash that he knows that his father, Reverse Flash, was moved. And they go looking for him and they can't find him. They find Amanda Waller. And they think Amanda Waller has him, and she doesn't. So now they're going to find somebody to send into Belle Reve to find out where, the Reverse Flash is, and enter the Boomerang to be continued. Interesting. Once again, one of the reasons why I moved this to a digital pile for right now is because the stories are okay. They're average. Nothing amazing. I will be getting the button, as we all know, when the button comes out, and we're going to get Jay Garrick back, maybe. I got to get that. New Superman. I'm starting to regret having it as a digital. I might go back and buy the last four issues, including this one and next month's. This is issue number 9. I dropped this, I think, one story arc too early. I like this. So Lex Luthor comes to, I forgot where, whatever place where New Superman is, and wants to bring Kenan back to America to show him, you know, we're Superman. We are on the same team. We're both superheroes. And he wants Kenan's help with something. And I love how Kenan brings his sensei with him. And the sensei's like, there's something wrong here. You're taking the easy route with Lex, because Lex is like, I'm going to find a way to give you your powers back full force, permanent. And it involves this door. And I love how the teacher's like, Kenan, sometimes we have to work hard for what we want. The easy route usually leads to disaster and problems. And what happens? Kenan doesn't listen.
And he takes the easy route.
And he goes for the doors, and the sensei says, I'm gonna stand by you. Even I love it's funny. This is why I think I gotta get this book physically again. He said, even though you're making the dumbest decision of your life, I'm gonna stand by you through it all. So he opens the door, he gets his powers back. However, he opens the door to hell.
Oh no.
Oh yes. And you got this other force, and this plays into the Super Sons book, which is going to be interesting to read that. I haven't read anything that came out this past week yet. I will starting tonight. But it's the people that have been breaking into LexCorp, and they're Mandarin, and they want the door, and they know that what Lex is doing is dangerous, so they try to stop him and Kenan, and a fight breaks out to be continued.
Wow.
Oh, man. It's really good stuff. And apparently we get introduced to the Mandarin Flash, the Chinese Flash.
Yeah.
Very interesting. Very. Can't wait to see what happens next.
All right. Deathstroke issue number 14. The book is getting...
Uh-oh.
How can I explain this?
Well, you just went,
Basically, Deathstroke is going after this guy, and he thinks that Dexter sent him out to kill him. And he said that he was supposed to bring him in, but of course Deathstroke is one of the people that killed him. They also changed his costume a little bit, like the front part of the costume, like it had like a little snake thing like costume. Like I don't know how to describe or anything, but yeah. Then we get into Rose's side where she has something that she can't translate to read, and then here's the part where I was like, why? It seems
definitely a wicked cover.
It seems that now Deathstroke is blind. Why is Deathstroke blind?
He's not going to stay blind.
Why? Why are they making him blind?
They're not going to keep him blind.
I hope not, because if this is going towards a route where he's going to be like another Daredevil, then I don't know. But
how has Deathstroke Rebirth as a whole been?
At first, it was good. Until they ended after the Deathstroke versus Superman, that's when it got a little bit down south. Mm. And also Deathstroke with Athene, where Jericho doesn't know that he was with her.
Mm.
Definitely bad. Spider-Man Deadpool issue number 15, Till Death Do Us Part, Part 2. Like before, random adventure where they're...
Hashtag blind Deathstroke.
So... Spider-Man Deadpool They're fighting off against these chaotic creatures that are coming onto the Marvel Universe, as always. And the only thing I could say is their solution, or Deadpool's solution, to end all this is to bring Dracula. Which is going to lead into part three of Death to Us Part, and Deadpool
Burns
for money.
Please next.
Yeah, agreed. Power-Man Iron Fist, issue number 14.
When you said Dracula, I was done. Speaking of Iron Fist, stay tuned, everybody. Brant and I will be live watching Iron Fist, hopefully by 12 o'clock, and depending on how long it takes Mike to talk.
And I did review this on Comic Frontline. Basically, it's Alex Wilder, who possesses the Super Soul Stone, Power-Man Iron Fist with Senior Majestic, I don't know how you say his name, are looking for it. They're going around asking about this thing that's known as the drug that Alex Wilder's selling. They have the octopus creature. Jenny betrays him.
The octopus creature.
Jenny betrays him and takes the octopus box. No, seriously, true story. And brings it to Power-Man Iron Fist.
This is not right.
Oh, but wait, there's more.
Oh, no, more.
There's more. The octopus.
Oh, dear Christ.
Brought in not only Jenny in the box, but Iron Fist in the box. When Power-Man's holding on, oh, boy, what they see inside that octopus is a...
I don't want to know what's in the octopus.
You don't want to know because guess what? It's going to be in full to be continued in the next part. You can check my full review on Comic Frontline about that. Wow, this issue is packed.
What is wrong with people and octopus? Have you guys checked Future Quest out? It's yes, I've been reading Future Quest, dude.
My man.
You've been on my reviews, Jeremy. You know I review Future Quest.
What an issue.
I have issue number 3 on my wall. See Birdman?
Yeah. Okay. Coming out of this great issue.
All new Wolverine issue number 18. Oh, I've been waiting for this. I've been waiting for this since this arc started. Laura is no longer controlled. I had some plastic on me, I don't know why, by the trigger scent. And when they come to get her, because I'm going to leave out all the beginning because you guys just got to read it for yourself. But when they come for Laura and they throw the trigger scent in, where is it? Come on. Eventually, it will show up.
Eventually.
Mm-hmm.
It talks about me talking. Eventually.
Anyway, they throw the trigger scent. Yep, there it is. And nothing happens. And Kimura's like, what the hell? And then I love how X-23, or she's Wolverine now, Laura says, meet Jean Grey. She helped me. She basically saved me. So now it's all
about
fighting.
Wait a minute. Isn't Jean Grey supposed to be dead? In this universe?
The young one, remember?
Oh, okay. I thought they were in the future. Oh, okay.
And then we find out that X-23 never killed those people in the village, that when the mist was dropping, she basically put her claws through her brain. It was her that did it. So now X-23 is off the hook completely. She's free. She fights Kimura. I'm not going to say how she defeats Kimura, but she's like, I am Wolverine. I'm the daughter of Logan and the daughter of Sarah. I have to make sure about names. And that's it. Kimura's gone. X-23 was free of her crimes because she didn't commit them. And she's just free, period.
Wow.
Things are looking up for X-23. All new Wolverine. Excellent series. Cannot wait for the next story arc and the new
series. Even I heard that Logan movie was good.
Beagle was still illustrated. Yeah, Mark Bagley. Beagle or Bagley, do you mean? Or Bengal. Who's illustrating this book now?
I think Varela.
Varela.
Yeah.
I mean, he might come back at some point, but I liked X-23. I'm all new Wolverine all the way through. Now, this was a weak book for me, and that's Supergirl issue number 7. I didn't like it. It goes Bengal. Okay, I'm sorry. Then I have to look up the artist again. I don't really... One thing, Frog Queen, I got to say is writers I'm a little more familiar with, and like certain artists I really don't delve too deeply into unless I have a quarrel or a super delight. I really don't quarrel too deep into that. Varela is great too. I mean, her Deadpool was amazing. Okay. Honestly, if it fits the book, if it works great, then that's great. If I notice an artist, that means it's really good or really bad. Same thing with a writer. If it's really good or really bad. So Supergirl, I couldn't get into this issue because Supergirl, long story short, she uses a machine to go into the mind of the Kryptonian werewolf to find out what triggers the transformation, if it's really the moon or not. And it is the moon, but it's not the sight of the moon or the ability of the moon. It's the memories that are connected to the moon and the harshness that is his father. And when she figures out how to help him, which is basically he just needs therapy, that'll be the way to keep the werewolf inside of him. And then we get what I've been waiting for.
Let me see.
Superman! Because that means the Legion of Superheroes is next.
Well, you had to know Superman was going to appear in a Supergirl comic book eventually.
Oh, yeah. I'm looking forward to this meeting. Yeah. And the weaker of the two stories with Wonder Woman, which is God Watch, is issue number 18. Again, we're delving more into Veronica's past and why she's the evil person that we see in. So basically, God Watch is the year one to what's going on in Wonder Woman currently. So the current story is still the odd number. The past stories are in the even numbers. And we get a little bit more about her friend that she brings back to life through the machine, and she becomes Dr. Cyber. We find out we see more of the relationship with Wonder Woman and Barbara Ann before she becomes, Cheetah. We find out that it's not Wonder Woman's fault that she gives Barbara Ann a communicator and says, "If you need me, call me." You know, and she gives her the communication device, and Barbara Ann does call her. But Veronica makes sure, number one, that Wonder Woman won't get the call when Barbara Ann calls her for help. And then she keeps her busy as well. And then finally, when Wonder Woman does show up, it's too late. Because now Barbara Ann is the Cheetah. And they basically end the book with them fighting. And Veronica, you see, I mean, there's some redeeming qualities with Veronica too. Because now she regrets what she's doing, but she's doing it to save her daughter. All manipulation from the gods. Gotta love it. Gotta love it. And this apparently is about a year or two. This is the past. This takes place in the past.
Yep. Next.
Oh, I've been waiting for the Legion of Superheroes to come into the Rebirth universe. Hopefully they will be a hit on this round. Me too, man. When they did New 52 Legion, it just didn't feel right. Even though they kind of admitted that there's the New 50, there was the New 52 or the paradox, the Flashpoint paradox that happened that ruined the universe for a bit, which confirms that maybe things will get better. I just didn't like, and Legion Lost I didn't like at all. I loved in Rebirth that we got Saturn Girl in Arkham Asylum, and we saw the ring, and we saw the little thing during, I believe it was Detective Comics, where she put the Legion symbol in like that mist that she made in the window. It's gonna be good, I'm telling you.
Yep.
All right. Speaking of Detective Comics, Detective Comics 952, the League of Shadows attacks. And we find out that the leader of the League of Shadows is actually Orphan. It's her mom. And Orphan does not take this well. And we find out that Cassandra's mom knew that she gave her up a long time ago, and when Cassandra finds out that that's her mother, and Batman, who fought Shiva before, actually warns her that, you know, she's not going to win. She's like, "I let you win those times. Now I'm playing for keeps." And she ends up stealing Batwing and what's his name? Batwing and, oh man, Azrael. Azrael ends up getting taken, but then they bring Duke in, who still doesn't have a name, by the way. Duke is still no clue what Duke's name is. And now they're trying to find the two. And I love how Batwoman's father's like, "You had your chance. You blew it. Now run because it's too late. They're going to destroy Gotham, and they're going to take you down with it. So you just got to run." And Cassandra kind of has a bit of a breakdown by the end of the issue, figuring out that Shiva is actually her mother. And she's like, "Why? Why her? Why is she my mom of all people?" And I feel for Cassandra because her father was, well, the person that raised her was an ass. Her mother is even eviler than he is. You are the daughter. You are a superhero who happens to be the daughter of a really evil bitch and a really twisted dude. I pretty much don't follow the big two series closely. I'm bitter about how expensive they are. Frog Queen, I understand. That's why Michael and I order from DCBS. Basically, DCBS, the price tag says $2.99, but when you order from DCBS 2 months in advance, it's 40% off. So you can't get a better deal. And they actually sometimes, especially if it's a big book, they give you a bigger discount. Sometimes they take 50% off just so that you can get, you know, they make sales on the book. So honestly, if you really want to think about getting back into the big two, oh yeah, DCBS. Somebody in the comments, please link this wonderful woman. I'm going to do it because if you want to get back into new books, you need this link. You definitely need, open the new tab so I can get the link. You need this link because this was Brandt, Jay's, and a few other people. It doesn't matter you're in Canada. It's just the difference in shipping. The prices are still the same. Website, check it out. Maybe the shipping isn't really that bad. And also, you could choose monthly, bi-weekly, or weekly. Maybe just do monthly. Get it at the end of the month. Yeah, you'll be a little behind, but you know what? You will save a bunch of money on your comics. This was a godsend and why Michael and I can get more comics because we get 40% off on everything. Very true. That's why I only buy Amazing Spider-Man. Again, DCBS.com, great prices, great sales. And if not for them, if we were still buying from Midtown, number one, our comics would get here late. Number two, we'd be paying a lot more. We save a bunch of money. If we were spending $400, we're now spending $250, maybe $200. Just saying, there is a huge sale discount with DCBS. Yes, you have to order a few months in advance, but it's worth it. I get all my comics. Oh, I got you. I might have something for you, Frog Queen, later. Then also, we'll have to talk personally on my channel or through messages. Message me on my channel or something, and we'll talk definitely. But anyway, Hal Jordan and the Green Lantern Corps, issue number 16. Guy Gardner versus Arkillo, and the fight is epic. I loved it. We had some memories of when Guy was beaten up by his dad, and he's just not giving up the fight. I mean, Arkillo really beats the hell out of him for a while.
Wow.
And he's like, nope, you ain't going to win. I'm not going to let you. Now, the Guardians have something they want to do with Saint Walker, which they want Saint Walker. They're glad he's back because now he's going to reignite the blue light of hope. And we got John Stewart, who shows up to help Guy Gardner, who's basically he just loses it at a point, and the fight goes from Arkillo basically destroying Guy to Guy really wiping the floor with Arkillo. And I'll tell you this, I'm not going to spoil the ending, but man, let's just say both of them went all out, and I'd be surprised if both of them come out the same after this.
All right, my turn. Red Hood and the Outlaws, issue number 8. Who is Artemis? Prologue. And I really like Artemis' story, actually. It was really interesting, and it relates to her encountering with Wonder Woman. And she talks about, really, her story to Jason Todd, you know, about being at, what was that land called, that only woman? The one that Wonder Woman's on.
Themyscira.
Thank you, Themyscira. So she talks about her adventures in Themyscira. And she had a training buddy who she trained with. I want to show some artwork with Wonder Woman in it because it was like really good artwork they were showing.
While you do that,
here it is. Wonder Woman, right there. So she talks about how she encountered with Wonder Woman, and you know what they're looking for was the Bow of Ra, and as they were going on the adventure. She's just saying, you know, I will not stand for all the chaos that you're causing, Artemis. So they have a little bit of a fight scene. And the fight was like really something else. So they did find the Bow of Ra, and we see what it does in this story. So, and it killed her friend, Akilla, and something like that. So now it's now the hunt for the Bow of Ra to see, you know, if she could find it and everything. So, it was lost as from what they said. So now they're going to be going to look for it. So Artemis's story is really interesting. So I guess the next issue is going to be part 2 of Artemis's story. I'm really not sure. But Let me tell you though, Red Hood and the Outlaws, I love how they dove into Bizarro's story, and now they're going into Artemis's story. So, because I believe they went to, yeah, they did go into Jason Todd's and Rebirth. I had to remind myself that. Look at that. And I have to see about that. So, definitely gonna, excuse me, get the next issue and see how this turns out. Got a really terrible cough tonight. But yeah, great issue for Red Hood and the Outlaws.
Okay. Superwoman, issue number 8. Or basically, Lana in a dream world. Lana is fighting herself, basically. She's finally confronting Lois and Clark and her brother and everything.
Oh,
and,
wow.
And basically, a lot of self-pity. There is a lot of self-pity in Lana. And one thing I really did like, though, in this all of this dialogue that happened, one of the things I loved is, she's like, John Henry loves me so much, and I don't love him. Why couldn't you, Clark, love me the same way that John loved me, that I can't love John? So no matter what, no matter how much John loves Lana, there's that piece of Lana that loves him, but not as deep as he loves her. And he's like, why always you? Why is it always you and Superman to Lois? She's like, why is it always the two of you? She's like, I just have to accept that. You know what? Screw that. And it's like, why are you?
Oh, don't tell me they're gonna make Lana bad now.
No. She's good. But the one question she always asks Lois before and Superman before they leave, because apparently this is some type of a dreamscape slash possibly her giving her powers up, is why you two? Why is the world? Why does the world rotate around you two? And she's like, it's not the two of us. And she's like, it's not the two of us, it's our son. And she's like, but you don't have a. And then she stops talking and realizes, oh my god, I understand now. So I think John is some type of, is going to be the key.
Oh, to, I love that splash
rebirth page. And then they redid the splash page again from the first issue, except this time they added Lana to it, and I thought that was really awesome. However, we find out that Lana is still inside that machine, that robot, and she's still healing. Next issue, they claim she'll be coming back, so we'll have to wait and see how that goes. But really, I'm really digging Superwoman.
All right. Next one for you.
Titans issue number 9, the Fearsome Five cry, we have been rehabilitated. We are not evil anymore. We opened this organization to help people, to make people, you know, to help people with superpowers that don't want them or that need a way to manage them. And Bumblebee's like, wait a minute. That's the guy that, when they get back to Titan's Tower, she's like, that's Mammoth? That's the guy that attacked you, Mal? Why didn't you tell me? I finally had a handle on my powers, and you mean to tell me that it's being handled by supervillains?
That's crazy.
So what happens are the Titans come up with a plan where Flash and Nightwing are going to do some detective work. They're going to break into the corporation at Meta U, I believe it is, or Meta Solutions, and find out what the hell's going on and if they're really on the up and up or not. And while they're in there, they find out real quick that Meta Solutions is not on the up and up. And we have a fight between the Titans, Nightwing and Flash versus Mammoth. And Mammoth has more power than he had before, and the Titans go over there because they don't hear from Nightwing and Kid Flash, and then you got Bumblebee, who's also suiting up and going towards that building. And, yeah, so the Fearsome Five are not rehabilitated, and there's a plan in place, and I can't wait to see what it is. Titans is definitely picking up on me. I'm glad they're not focusing on anybody anymore. It's literally the Titans again. I like the feel of this book a lot.
All right. Justice League of America, issue number 2. Things are getting really chaotic with the Justice League team. Havoc is spreading lots of harm to the city. And Batman's like saying, you know, don't use them as an example. Use me, because he was playing the sacrifice. So we have this, what's his name? Dr. Die Hard, who looks like Magneto or reminds me of Magneto. And I love the artwork, though.
Oh, wait, a lot of comics about me. Yeah, of course, because their marketing is so tight. Yeah, exactly.
The artwork is really, really good in the Justice League of America comic. And yeah, lots of dicey stuff happened in this comic book with Batman's team.
Alan, yes, Alan, it was.
Oh, Alan's there? Oh.
Alan popped in finally. My star moderator is in the house.
Yeah, and now Havoc is actually saying his plans of what he wants to do, which does not look good. So I don't think this is going to be the last time we see Havoc.
And the good news is I've reviewed the last book on this review, so I don't have to really go too in-depth. And it is Action Comics, issue number 975. If you'd like to see my full review on this book, you can go over to the solo review of it. Really quickly, the big reveal for this issue is that the Clark Kent, and everybody knows this by now, so it's no surprise, that the Clark Kent is Mitzel Pidlick. And I don't care if I'm saying his name wrong. Millions of people call him Mitzelflick.
Isn't that
Mitzelflick still?
Isn't that the guy, the one that tricked Superman to doing lots of stuff? Oh boy.
So we find out that he did it because he wanted to set things right with Superman. He wanted, you know, he said the world knew that Clark Kent was Superman. That wasn't right. And it didn't make sense. And I don't think that Mitzelflick knows that. And John tries to explain it to him in the secondary story. I think he believes that Superman just forgot about him. I don't think he realizes that a paradox has happened. The world is not the same, and Dr. Manhattan and Ozymandias are now running the world from high up above somewhere in the nothing space. And I think when he finds out that, oh, shoot, wait a minute, there was another Superman, the universe was changed, I think that's when it's going to snap, because right now he's super evil.
Wow.
I can't wait for the next issue, which is out now, and I'm going to read it right after this review, but man, oh man, the reveals and everything. You can go check out my almost 15-minute review on this book.
15 minutes?
I spoke a lot about it. It's on Comic Frontline. You can go check it out right after this. Check the comments really quick. JLA has a great team dynamic, cool use of powers, good banter from everyone. It should have been John Kent from another Earth. Oh, wow. Mitzel. It is. It's going to be very interesting. So with that, that's it for this review, everybody.
Yep.
As always, number one, thank you, everybody who was with us live. All the new faces, hopefully we will be seeing you on other live shows right here on Comic Frontline, such as the one that is going to be happening in approximately 20-ish minutes with me and Brant. We are going to be continuing our live viewing of Iron Fist episode 5 through ? Our goal is to get through the entire series before the end of the weekend. Will it happen? Who knows? But we're going to start from episode 5 and we're going to see how far we can get from episode 5. Also, we have Frontline Live every Tuesday. Media Madness this week is Wednesday and Saturday, so you get a double dose of Media Madness, which is awesome. And also, my channel, got a lot of stuff going on there, dropping little hints. There's a series that's happening right now, one video a week. I got sick this week. The video is going to be a bit late, but it is one video a week for X amount of weeks until the big... Shebang. At the end. Shebang's a good word. Yeah, shebang's a good word. But yeah, as always, what's up, Shamar? We're ending the show now, unfortunately. Double J and Cat, can the world handle it? I don't know. And can the world handle a possible special guest on one of those Media Madnesses? No names will be dropped.
No
names will be dropped yet. But thank you all so much. If you did not catch this live, you are more than welcome to comment below your thoughts on any of the books we talked about. Agree, disagree, likes, dislikes, feel free to leave them in the comments below. We love hearing from you guys. If you're new to this channel, like I've been saying, hopefully you will, for those of you that are new live, you guys will pop around on other live shows we do, other live shows I do, other live shows that all of us do on all of our different channels. Also, there's that little subscribe button down below with the bell. Bell us, subscribe to us. We are Comic Frontline, your number one source for comic-related news, reviews, and a whole bunch more. We got videos coming out each and every day, even the weekend. We have no lives. No, that's a lie. We do have lives.
That was a good one.
But we do, and we also have our gaming channel, Frontline Gaming Zone, and I'm sick right now. Oh, I'm sorry, Frog Queen. I'm getting over it. Mike's getting over it. A lot of people are getting sick right now. And for cards, we have What the Card, where we open up tons of Pokemon cards and Yu-Gi-Oh! On the weekend.
Yep.
So, till next time, everybody. Take care. I'll see you guys soon. I don't know if Mike will be there for Iron Fist, but we'll see you guys soon regardless. Take care. Have a great night. We'll see you soon in the next video.
Hey, everybody.